Dear students, I, Shukumar S. Ladde, Department of Pharmacology, Shulingeshwar College of Pharmacy, Almala. Today we learn regarding anatomy and physiology of liver. Learning outcomes: upon completion of this video, students should able to describe the anatomy and physiology of liver. Dear students, the liver is a second largest organ of the body after the skin. The liver is a dual organ having both secretory and excretory functions. The liver is the organ is located in the upper right part of the abdomen, and it is the beneath the diaphragm and top of the stomach and right kidney and intestines. And an average weight of liver is a 1.5 kg. Dear students, the liver is covered with a fibrous layer known as the Gilson's capsules, and these Gilson's capsules, it can divide the liver into a right lobe and left lobe by a attachment of the falciparum ligament. There are two further accessory lobes or arises from the right lobe and left lobe, so with the visceral surface liver, that is caudate lobe and caudate lobes. So this is the right lobe and left lobe, then caudate lobe. It is located on the lower aspect of the visceral surface. It lies between the gallbladder and fossa, produced by the ligaments tears. Then caudate lobe. It is located on the upper aspect of visceral surface. It lies between the inferior vena cava and fossa, produced by the ligamentum venosum. Dear students, the liver having the some fissures or crack. So these fissure or crack on the liver, it can allow the entry and exit of the blood vessels and entry of the various nerves and lymphatic blood vessels. So these are, it consists of allow the entry of one hepatic artery, hepatic duct, portal vein, that is nerve sympathetic and parasympathetic mammatics, and as well as the lymphatic vessels. Hepatic artery, it can supply the oxygenated blood about 25%, and remaining 75% of blood circulations can be covered by the portal vein. So the portal vein carries the deoxygenated blood along with the nutrients from the small intestine and various part of the large intestines. Now we learn regarding the physiology of liver. So liver play important role in the metabolism of carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, hormones and many drugs. Dear students, the liver is also play important role in the production of the bile. And liver is also having a synthetic functions. It is involved in the synthesis of glucose, proteins, clotting factors, plasma proteins, steroids, heparin and somatostatin. Livers play important role in the regulations of the body weight, because due to metabolism the heat is produced, so that heat is helpful for the regulations of the body heat. Then liver is also acts as a storehouse for glycogen, that is excess of glucose in the form of glycogen, amino acids, iron, folic acid, vitamin A, B12 and D. The liver is also play important role in the hemopoietic functions, that is the productions of the blood cells in the intrauterine life, because it acts as a storehouse for the vitamin B12, and as well as in intrauterine life the RBM is not developed. Then over the liver is the only one organ along with spleen and thymus gland, so they are involved in the productions of the blood cells. Excretory functions, so liver play important excretions of cholesterol, bile pigments, heavy metal, toxins, bacteria, viruses through a bile. Destructions of RBC is also done in a liver, because the liver is consists of special type of cells. Those are known as the reticuloendothelial cells or Cooper cells. So these cells are helpful for the destruction of the RBC. And due to destruction of RBC, the heme and protein can be separated, and they are required for the further formations of the RBC or hemoglobin. Liver is also play important role in the conversions of poisonous ammonia into urea. So now we learn how the liver is involved in the productions of the bile. So dear students, the liver is having the hepatocytes. So these hepatocytes are the special type of the cells of the liver. So those are involved in the metabolism of cholesterols. So these hepatocytes metabolize the cholesterol into a primary bile acids. The primary bile acids are taurocholic acids, taurokinodeoxycholic acid, glycocholic acids, and glycohinodeoxycholic acids. So these all are the unconjugated bile acids. And further, these unconjugated bile acids conjugate with the glycine and taurine to form a conjugated bile acids. And these conjugated bile acids are cholotaurins, cholyl glycines, quinodeoxycholitaurins, and quinodeoxycholyglycines, and they are secreted into a small intestines. From the small intestines, so they are enter into the large intestine. In the large intestine, the bacterial flora was present. So those bacterial flora, they can convert so these primary bile acids into a secondary bile acids like lithocholic acid and deoxycholic acid. And these lithocholic acid and deoxycholic acid, so they are enter in the liver through a hepatic circulation or enterohepatic circulation with the help of the portal vein. So where, so these secondary bile acids, they are conjugated with the glycine and taurines and secreted into the, that is the primary bile acids like potassium glycolate and potassium taurolate. Then so this primary or bile salts like potassium glycolate or taurate, they are component of the bile. Then the bile was stored in the gallbladder. So like that, the bile can be produced, and bile is golden yellow or greenish color. Then its pH is a 8 to 8.6, and volume is 800 to 1200 ml per day, and the specific gravity is 1.010 to 1.011. Thank you, dear students.